and loves. Today I'm going to show you all of the many textures of my hair. So this is my hair fresh out of the shower, no product whatsoever. It is a shrunken afro, as you can see, and it's pretty awesome. It feels cool. So the middle of my hair, it has really not a ton of texture, kind of a corkscrewish pattern in a way. And on the edges of my hair is where the loosest part of my texture is. As you can see, it kind of has an S-curl pattern in a way, and it's mixed in with kind of hair that has no texture at all. And it doesn't shrink as much as the rest of my hair. The same thing on the other side. This side actually has a looser S-curl pattern, as you can see, and yeah, the bottom layer is a lot looser, and then you can see how each inch of my head kind of changes texture really drastically. It's really interesting, and it doesn't shrink like the rest. I literally have to push it up and make it small. So this is my hair in the back. The cool thing about it is, you see, I've pulled it down. It hits about where my birthmark is, and the other side is longer. It always grows that way. It has super grow in it. It's weird. It's crazy, but it's kind of cool. I cut it a lot. I cut it a lot, and it still grows long. So the front of my hair really has no texture. It's very similar to the back, and that's about it. So this is what my hair looks like if I were to dry it with a t-shirt or a towel or something like that. No product. And I actually wore my hair out like this once before. So that's my hair. Those are the textures, and I hope you enjoyed.
So as you all can see, once my hair is stretched, even when it's towel dry, it looks all the same texture. It's very deceiving. And I know that there are a lot of you guys out there who have similar textures to me who can probably relate to that. It's a little interesting, but I like it. And in a way, because it looks so uniform when it's dry, I guess I could say I'm a little blessed. So a couple other tidbits I want to add. I think this side of my hair seriously has super grow in it. I won't be surprised when I do my length check if this side is longer than this side. I don't know, all right? Now that my hair is a little bit longer, I tend to wash my hair every other week rather than every week in my hair regimen wash video that I'll link down below, because it's a lot easier to do it every other week, and I think my hair likes less shampoo now, and if it gets really dry and I don't want to shampoo it, I'll just co-wash it. I trim my hair about every 4 months. It varies depending on if I'm, you know, doing an experiment or whatnot. Like, how long does it really take to get my hair to the state where I need to trim it? You know what I mean? So the last time I waited a little bit longer, but it always averages out to about 4 months before I trim. And as you can see, my hair has a ton of shrinkage when it's wet, and when I stretch it out, it's a lot fuller, a lot longer looking, and I think it's pretty amazing that my hair can do that. Also, I know I've mentioned this before, but my edges are a lot thinner in terms of the hair is very fine, and there's a lot less strands in this area. Alopecia runs in my family, and so the females in my family actually have alopecia. It's basically a condition where you're pretty much balding in certain spots of your head. In my family, it's hereditary, and of course, you know, getting relaxers and things like that doesn't really help it. So I think it may have skipped me and my sister, but because my edges are so thin, I wonder if that trait is still there. So I'm not sure. It may have skipped me, but I can see kind of the remnants of that trait in my family because my edges are so thin. So with all that being said, I just want to thank you guys for supporting me so far. I transitioned for 8 months. I am now 2 years natural, from October 8th, 2012. So I'm a little older now, but you know, it's about 2 years. Thank you so much for your support. So with that being said, I want to leave you all with some kind of hair styling, like bonus features, bonus pictures of some of my hairstyles from this whole like second year. And I hope you guys enjoy. I hope you're inspired, and there will be pretty much tutorials for almost all of the looks, if not most of them, down in the description bar. I love you guys, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.